Hey guys, welcome back to a brand new video. In this video, we are going to talk about some new signings and especially why I bought a goalkeeper for over 1,000 euros and explain why you probably shouldn't do the same as me because this is a very risky trade. So everything I say in this video is for my personal gallery and because I love some of these players I have signed and also sold some players in my gallery. So don't take any of the things I say in this video as advice. You can watch and learn, but please do your own research. But without further ado, let's jump right into the video. And remember to use the link in the description if you haven't signed up to Sorare already. So the player I have signed is André Onana. And you're probably wondering why I bought him and also how I got the money. I have deposited a bit of Ethereum into the gallery and I bought him on auction. And I also sold some other players. One is João Palhinha. I sold him when the Bayern München rumors came out. We can go on rare here, and yeah, I'm not on premium at the moment, but I sold him around here. And if we go to his SO5 scores, he hasn't been doing so well after the deadline, so I'm pretty happy with the timing of my sale. We can see I sold him for 188 euros. I am in general very happy with that. And he sold him further to 130 euros. So he didn't lose too much either. So that's what we love to see. We also sold Cristian Alvarez, goalkeeper from Real Zaragoza. He's currently looking at the same price. And we also sold Dominic Solanke. And he's actually gone up a bit because he scored against Brighton, which was a pretty tough fixture. We also sold Joachim Andersen. I believe his price was way too good and he was also at home against Fulham. So I expected him to do very well and that his price was going to be at the height. We also sold Bryce Mendes recently for 14 euros. Like this is the last season card, so I sold him after the 97 score. But the reason for picking up Onana, I have a few reasons. One of the most important reasons is that I'm currently building a new collection. And that's a Manchester United collection. I will make a video about this tomorrow or the day after that, explaining why I think United is one of the best teams to build a collection of. It's some negatives and some positives, but I will make a specific video about that because it's a pretty large topic and it's a very big gallery change for me. And I think I need a whole video to explain pros and cons and also concrete examples of other teams you can build a collection of, like the new season cards. But one of the main reasons for me purchasing the Manchester United collection was actually André Onana. Because I think 1,000 euros above that actually, I think I bought him for around, if we go to here and go to rear, Josalda, I bought him for 1,142 euros. And we can see, yeah, he's going for about that now. My planning and the reason for me looking in on André Onana especially is because he has a contract until 2028 for Manchester United. And he will stay at the club for at least 2 to 3 more years as the number one goalkeeper. I'm pretty confident in him staying, and we also have bought a second goalkeeper, Bayındır, from Turkey, I believe. And he is set to be the second choice goalkeeper. So I don't think Manchester United will sign a new goalkeeper. André Onana was very expensive. And I feel in general, he is a player I can build experience on throughout this season and have him in many years. He will be my main goalkeeper for a long time. I trust Ten Hag's project, and I hope Manchester United can be even better in the upcoming seasons with the players they have, and also with Andre Onana in goal. And also, a big part of this is the midweeks. And also, the run of fixtures Manchester United have. Crystal Palace, Galatasaray, Brentford, Sheffield United, Copenhagen, Manchester City, Fulham, Copenhagen again, Luton, Everton, Galatasaray. Like, Manchester City is a very tough fixture, but other than that, very good run of fixtures. And also, I bought him before the 79 points against Burnley. Manchester United looked very bad, unfortunately. But they used a very bad team. And also, I feel like if Manchester United can go on a good run of form, I think Onana is one of the best goalkeepers to have, because he's very good with his feet. He gets a lot of possession points when United play in possession. And I think against Crystal Palace, he's just a perfect option. Against Galatasaray, very good. At home as well. And then Brentford at home. United tend to be very good at home. Sheffield United should be a very good fixture. They lost like 8-0 to Newcastle. Copenhagen, also a fantastic fixture on paper. And I just feel like he's a bit, like, he isn't undervalued. Because it's a lot of money for a goalkeeper. But I feel like the pros are just, there are too many pros. And I spend a lot of time thinking about this move. And it's a big commitment. But me personally believe at the end of the 23 to 24 season, I may actually earn up the money on the Manchester United players. Especially, not especially Onana, but hopefully Onana as well. Like, he's just too expensive, so I don't believe I will make up all the money on him. But I'm not going to go into the Manchester United collection thing. I'm going to just talk specifically about Andre Onana. And I think, like, the collections will just be more and more important with experience being so important. And I think of Soria as a long-term project for me, and he's a big part of that. And we can also see at Inter he had some very nice scores. Some concerning to see those DNPs, but keep in mind Handanovic was at the club, and Onana, I mean, Ten Hag isn't a big fan of rotation. So I just believe that Andre Onana will be the first choice goalkeeper. The only real concern is if he gets an injury. That's the only downside, and that I can lose a lot on him. But like, that's, you can't like make decisions and have that in your back head. Like, that, it doesn't work that way. But yeah, I think he's a very good option. But one thing I will say, if you aren't making a Manchester United collection, or you aren't a fan of Manchester United, there is so many more better options in goal than Andre Onana. Like, the only thing I think people aren't realizing about Manchester United and Andre Onana is that Manchester United have had a very tough start to the season. And when I say that, I mean the opponents. Manchester United haven't done too badly. Like, I can mention, out of all these games, Manchester United have had two or three very bad performances. Against Burnley, when they actually won. Against Brighton, where they lost 3-1. And also against Wolves. I don't think Manchester United played too bad against Tottenham. I don't think Manchester United played too bad against Arsenal. I don't think Manchester United played too bad against Bayern München. The statistics looks way too bad. And now Manchester United have a very good run of fixtures, and I just hope that they can get back to the best form with Andre Onana in goal, which I have mentioned earlier, and also I used him this weekend. If we go here, Premier League special weekly scarcity. I really like this one. They have the monthlies here. You can, so that's very nice. But we can see here that Andre Onana did have a very good game. We have Issa Diop, Diogo Dalot, Casemiro and Willian. And I just hope that I can get a signed Premier League jersey. That would be very cool and very nice. I'm not too sure if I'm going to prioritize getting... now we are on Joao Palhinha. If we go on Andre Onana. I'm not too sure if we're going to prioritize playing the special weekly. Because that was also one of the things I wanted to try to win the signed jersey. But if we go scroll down here, we can see, yeah, Premier League special weekly scarcity. Top 30 wins a signed Premier League jersey from 22 to 23 season, like the last season. We are currently on 11th. But I'm not too sure if I'm going to like focus too much on it, because now we have a pretty good collection with Andre Onana in goal. But I think I will make a specific video about that in the future, where we talk about the Premier League special weekly scarcity. And I think I can make a very good and very fun YouTube video about opening that reward. But now, generally, if some of you want to buy expensive goalkeeper, there are many different options. We have Jan Oblak. He is the same price as ish the same price as my man what is called Onana. And yeah, we can see Atletico, like, he hasn't those peak scores as Onana have. But he as well have pretty good fixtures, so this one is actually a very good one to go for as well, if you have Atletico Madrid collection. And also we have players like, we have of course Ederson, but you need to pay a little bit more for him. Also Alisson. You need to pay, like, no, he's quite the same. So yeah, this is an interesting one. He's about the same, but Kelleher plays all the European games, and also Ederson is set to be the starter for Brazil. And also Alisson is 30 years old, 3 years older than Onana. Do we have other goalkeepers we can compare to Onana? And also, I'm a Manchester United fan. Like, you need to understand that's a big part of the decision. I love to watch Manchester United. And, like, it's so much easier to do decisions when you actually know the team. It's same with Leicester in rare. Like, I know the team. It's so much easier than when you have inside information. And when you, and Ten Hag is a player that doesn't rotate too much. And it's just so much easier that way. We have Icardio. Yeah, he's just stupidly expensive, but it's quite the same actually. But I think Onana is better than Vicario. Vicario, yeah, he's a bench player for Italy. But it's quite the same situation. I think he's way too overpriced, me personally. Like, Tottenham doesn't have European football, and they have pretty tough fixtures. I don't like Vicario at all. If you're going to buy a goalkeeper, I would rather than have Onana, me personally. Another negative on Onana, which I would say is, it's a bit low supply. We can see, if we go here, yeah, we can see only 3 cards on the market there. He have 83 cards. And that's, compared to limited, that's not little at all. Like, that's actually pretty good if we go to Ederson. I think Ederson have actually lower supply. Ederson have a lower supply, but much higher in limited. So that's one thing I need to say to you. Don't buy Onana in limited. He will go down under 70 euros. I swear to you. I don't swear to you, but I, like, that's pretty predictable. The rare amount and limited amount is almost the same. So I feel like in rare value, Onana is a much better deal than in limited. He will go down. We can check Alisson. And he's also Premier League keeper. Premier League keeper are always overpriced. And you have a bit of reinsurance unless he goes to Saudi Arabia. But as long as he will be the first choice goalkeeper in every single team, almost every single team in Europe at the moment. Of course, not in Liverpool or Chelsea or... In Chelsea would be first choice, but in Manchester City. But moving on, we can check Courtois. And also Ter Stegen can we check. Courtois is a bit undervalued actually, but he has an injury until 2024. That's not good. But he's just an extremely good goalkeeper. So for a long-term investment, he could be a very good one. But he's 31 years old, and it's not a good sign to have a so long injury. You don't know if he's going to recover 100%. And we have Ter Stegen. He is way too expensive. But like he's 31 years old, he has a long contract at Barcelona. Barcelona is a very dominant team. But I feel like that's way too expensive for a goalkeeper. Like, I can understand people picking up for that price, but me personally believe 2,000 euros, like, you're above... He has pretty good scores, don't get me wrong, but it isn't good enough to use so much money on him. Please comment your goalkeepers in the description. And my name has been Usolde. Thank you so much for watching this video. A very fun video to make. And I think tomorrow, because it was rewards video yesterday, I believe. And I think, if I'm not mistaken, we are going to make a Manchester United collection video where we specifically talk about that and what my plans are for the future with the Manchester United collection. And also in general, some tips and tricks for you guys that are currently making the new season collections. You want to save as much money as possible when you buy new collections. And I will of course come with my tips. Thank you so much. And I will of course see you on the next one. Bye bye and take care. Peace.